morning.
Good morning.
My name is Candy Cucas, and welcome to our celebration of the sixth Sunday of Easter. And happy Mother's Day. If you are watching us live on our Facebook stream, please feel free to comment your prayers, thoughts, and intentions. If you are watching us this morning on our website or DCAP, thanks for tuning in. And if you're watching us later today or this week on our YouTube channel, we hope this Mass brings you comfort. For those of you joining us in the church today, please remember to silence your electronic devices so that we may maintain the dignity and sacredness of our Mass. No matter where you are or how you got here, please know that you are always most welcome here at St. Richard Parish. The theme of today's liturgy is Christ died to bring us life in the Spirit. Let us give thanks and praise to God. Today's Mass is being offered for special intention. Our presider this morning is Father Bruce Lanigan. Our cantor is Maura Lynch, and our keyboardist is Jeff Patch.
Thank you.
Almighty God, that we may celebrate with heartfelt devotion these days of joy, which we keep in honor of the risen Lord, and that what we relive in remembrance, we may always hold to in what we do each day. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated and be open to God's word.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When Peter entered, Cornelius met him, and falling at his feet, paid him homage. Peter, however, raised him up, saying, "Get up. I myself am also a human being." Then Peter proceeded to speak and said, "In truth, I see that God shows no partiality. Rather, in every nation, whoever fears him and acts uprightly is acceptable to him." When Peter was speaking these things, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who were listening to the word. The circumcised believers who had accompanied Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit should have been poured onto the Gentiles also, for they could hear them speaking in tongues and glorifying God. Then Peter responded, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit, even as we have?" He ordered them baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be in you and your joy may be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves, because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you my friends, because I have told you everything that I have heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you, and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you, love one another." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It's so good to see faces and bodies back in the church, and it's been a long haul since December 19th. And last week was the first time we opened, and it allowed us and afforded us to be able to take the time to do a lot of changes within the structure of the church so that it would be a more pleasant experience throughout the year. Air conditioning is now a part of St. Richard's and works really nicely. And it's quiet. And I had it on even on the coldest day. A couple weeks ago, just to make sure that it was working. And we have all the new carpeting and the freshly painted this and cleaned that, and the windows look like someone put a light on, they were washed for the first time in 54 years. So it's the cleanest church in the Northeast, at least, maybe on the whole East Coast at this point. And so it's a great place to come and celebrate, and we're so pleased you're here. And having gotten notice that more and more restrictions are being eased, not in a crazy fashion, but in a safe fashion, so that we think that next week we know we're going to open to a number of 150 for this mass. And that's about, it's a little less than 50% of what we can put in here, but and that's where we're supposed to be, so. And we'll open slowly over the summer, more and more, and get back to something called normal, whatever that is. And hopefully God will guide us on all of that. I know he will if we just listen and follow the science and listen to the smart people and do the right things and remember that we're all in this together. I was talking to someone yesterday who, actually Andy Lane, just around the corner, the religious goods store, and he said that he got a call for something in a parish in Marlboro and needed to get it out there. So he got up really early yesterday morning, like 5 a.m., and drove out there and got it to them and got back worrying about the traffic, and he said there was none. And Marlborough was my first parish assignment as a brand new priest, Immaculate Conception, huge parish, and there were four priests, a deacon, massive rectory, it looked like Grand Central Station, and a huge church that I think we had six masses on the weekend. We had them downstairs, upstairs at the same time. It was just how it was 40-something years ago.
And I loved the place. And you know, as a brand new priest, you're excited to do what you've been trained to do and anticipating to do, and hospital calls and all that stuff that is part of our life, and being with people, and I found myself easily being swallowed up by the volume of work, and having had a lot more energy then than I do now, it was day and night. It seemed like 24 hours, but I know it was an average 16 hours a day, really nonstop in many ways. And by the time you hit the bed, you went out and you stayed out, unless you got a call to the hospital, which was often in the middle of the night for emergency room. But the energy was always exciting and uplifting, and so I found myself being swallowed up by the activity. And it was one day I was sitting in prayer for the few minutes that I took, and I really experienced the presence of God in a unique fashion for me at that time, because I realized I wasn't giving him much time at all. I was giving the parish endless amounts of time, but I wasn't giving him much time. And I thought of that gospel. I heard that, please love me as much as I love you, basically. And I wasn't spending time with him. I was doing his will, I thought, but I wasn't spending time with him. And you know, if you continue on that journey, you get burnt out. And as much as you think you're doing all the right things, dedicating your life to all of this, if you don't take a moment or two or 10 minutes to stop and renew your friendship with the person who has brought you to this point, the Lord Jesus, and yet you're not going to be successful. And you're not going to be complete. You're not going to be the human being God intended you to be. And that's true in every fashion of life, isn't it? So I started to spend a little more time in prayer, and it was refreshing. And I spent a little more time in friendship, and I found myself doing it more and more during the day, not just that one time I set aside in my schedule. And I found that the energy was wonderful, but I knew how to tame it then. I knew how to balance my life better. And I think of all the balance that you as a family, people as parents and children, you have to do, and as grandparents too. So many grandparents are raising the kids today. And you need to balance your time of refreshment and fulfillment with all of the other activity. And it's a full-time job, huh? But that's what God calls us to. And I've noticed over those many decades now, you can see right away that the families where the parents buy everything for the kids to keep them busy, but over there, because they're so caught up in their own stuff, and they never spend time as a family together. Maybe this past year has forced that issue. And you've made up for the last 30 years in 9 or 10 months, I don't know. But I've seen marriages fall apart. because people don't know how to spend time together. They don't take the time to just renew their own life. Somebody in my own family said this week, I was texting them back and forth, and he said, I hope to spend at least a breakfast with my husband before the weekend's over. In other words, we don't get a lot of time together. And you need to make that time, she was saying. So, love one another as I have loved you. Build a friendship. Keep moving in that direction and watch what happens. Be patient with one another and seek God's help and strength. It's a day-to-day experience that that we're called to love one another as He has loved us. It's a day-to-day experience to balance our lives. It's a day-to-day experience to realize that He wants to be a part of it all. He wants to bind our wounds. He wants to spend time listening to us and us to listen to Him. He wants us to be friend. And that calls us to an understanding more of this gospel too, that He says, I no longer call you slaves, I call you friends. And I was enslaving myself in the early years of my priesthood, especially that first two. I thought the more you did, the better you were at accomplishing God's work. And I was identifying my work as me. Does that make sense?
Yes.
And I'm much more than my work. And so aren't you. You're God's creation, put here to love one another. And we're called not to be slaves, but to be servant, to serve as Christ served. And we as a community are called to work at that service. I've always admired St. Richard Parish for the ability to serve others. You always found it almost easy, at least in my eyes, and I know it's a lot of work for you, but almost easy to serve by feeding the poor and the hungry, by helping those who are falling through the cracks. You know, we do a lot of different things over the year, and even in this struggle financially of this year, for all of us, Paris has had a tough struggle, but you've kept us afloat. And we've been able to contribute to those who are far worse off than us. And that's really so important. So important for our mission. Christ Jesus is our Lord and our Savior, given to us as a gift. And it's ultimately of importance to remember that God sent His only Son to die for us, for our poor choices, our sin, our self-centeredness, so that we can be relieved of that and find new life. And resurrection is a daily process. And resurrection is the promise of eternal life. We are entering into that mystery every time we come to church. Every time we set aside time to pray outside of this building, develop that friendship with Him. Every time we pick up the phone and call someone we know who is very isolated in this year of isolation. Say, I'm really thinking of you. You're special to me. I love you. And so we do that in amazing ways, in honoring the women in our lives today, the mothers of our parish and of our families, who are such a good example to all of us of what it means to love one another as he has loved us, being of service, sacrificing for the good of the whole, teaching us what it means to love. And it isn't always that romantic, beautiful, Hallmark call to love. It's the hard times to stay focused that is love as well. It's the times when you'd rather not get out of bed, but you got up and you did what you were supposed to do. It's love. When it's time to do the next right thing and you're really tired and you do the next right thing, that's love. And God will always be there to refresh you and renew you. And so, it's very dangerous to put an Irish Catholic priest in front of a captive audience for the first time in a long time. Because he doesn't know when to shut up. So I'll shut up. It's just really good to have you back here. Let's pray. Why are we here? I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us people and for our salvation, came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Loving God, we trust in your way. Time and time and time again, you have proven to us your love for us in the mystery of this life, and so we pray again.
That those searching for faith in a chaotic world encounter Christ in every member of the Church, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That nations cooperate to develop compassionate immigration policies, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For mothers everywhere, may they recognize the gift of their children and nurture them with joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have lost a child and all whose longing for children has gone unfulfilled, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all gather here see the face of Jesus in one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the intentions presented online today, and especially those held in the silence of our hearts, that the Lord hear them, heal them, and continue to bless us. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In thanksgiving for all of the mothers, both living and deceased, in our lives, for
they might be blessed unto eternity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, thank you for today. Help us to be generous in sharing your light and your love day by day through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For you see, at the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his own passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For you see, this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Peace.
who are helpful to us in keeping our parish open and moving in the right direction, and for those who have volunteered, the ushers and lectors and our music ministry and people who make sure we are able to stream the Mass to those who aren't able to come here today. For all of you, we're most grateful. I'm most grateful to God in blessing us in so many ways and keeping us safe. And so we are really blessed in so many ways. And we count them, we'll be up all day and all night. But I'd like to offer a blessing for all mothers today. So if you'd be so kind as to stand, just mothers.
Thank you for the gift of their sacrifice, of their joy, of their dedication to life, of their ability to make things whole when they are broken, to make a home where there is just a house. We thank you for their gift of patience and kindness and generosity, and we ask you to bless them in kind with all abundant love. And we ask this and give thanks through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And may he bless you, mothers, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let's pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Just a couple of quick notes. Again, next week we hope to open to a capacity somewhere around 150. And still we'll need to register if you are coming. Go online, register, make the reservation for the Lord's Supper. And thank you. Keep your mothers safe and sound today. Make sure that you don't have them out raking up the yard. Make sure they can sit and relax, and you wait on them hand and forth, and give them a joyful day. And you have a great day yourselves. Enjoy this weather, because tomorrow's supposed to be a little rainy. We need the rain, but we'd like at least 2 days in a row of sun someday. We have directions on how to receive Holy Communion. So good to see you. God bless you all.
Communion will be distributed from the back of the church as you leave Mass, row by row, exiting starting from the back, and will be directed by the usher. Parishioners may well decide not to receive Holy Communion if they feel the risk is too high, and that decision will be honored and respected. The communicants and Father Bruce will wear masks. Father Bruce will hold out the consecrated host over the communicants' outstretched hands and drop the host into their hands without touching their hands. Communicants will receive the consecrated host in their hands, exit the church, lower their mask, consume the host, and proceed to their car. In the case of an unintentional contact, the priest will sanitize his own hands immediately. Thank you, and have a wonderful week.
Thank you.